Thank you. My brief is to convince you that conventional jigs are the best. And as they say, old is gold. I don't consider myself old, not really. But I consider myself a mature surgeon after being in this business for 19 years and after 15,000 knees. So I would hope to give you a matured opinion on this topic. Now, we have been brought up on the premise that neutral mechanical axis is the goal. And there are several papers that tell you, you heard earlier as well, that anything beyond 3 degrees would lead to catastrophic failure. And I joined this CAS bandwagon. Thank you, Narendra, for showing my photograph there. I joined this CAS bandwagon about 10 years back, where every knee I was doing using CAS, and used CAS to refine my conventional, because it was not a routine CAS that I was doing. I was refining my conventional surgery technique, and I'll show you how. So I was actually putting the intramedullary jig along with the CAS pins, and I would put my pins obliquely so as to miss the intramedullary jig. And I would actually validate the distal femoral cut that I was taking with the conventional jig with the CAS in place. And this is the way I was doing total knee replacement for almost 2 years. That was almost nine, ten years back. Similarly, I would validate this. You can see that 0 degrees. Similarly, in the tibia, I would put my conventional jig, put my pins on the lower tibia, and validate my tibial cut like this. So this is the way I would validate all my cuts using CAS. In fact, it helped me immensely to validate my conventional surgery technique and get my cuts accurately. So this is what we're chasing at the end of the day, 0 degrees of varus to the mechanical axis and 0 degrees of tibial cut. We had a brief stint of EM navigation for a very short while that was being tested here. And in fact, the first global use of disposable navigation before it was approved by US FDA, the US team came down to us, our setup, and we used eye assist using 4 pods. And the first global use was done by me in our center. Unfortunately, I forgot to put an advertorial in the newspapers. And I think obviously that was my choice that I wouldn't do that. Similar with navigation, first navigation was done by me but never came out in the newspapers. And again, we're showing the same thing, showing 0 degrees. And just show you a picture of the first navigation that we did. So I can say that I've been there, I've done that, and I'm the last person to be against the technology or use of technology. And I believe today that I can deliver the same outcome without navigation. That is why my use of navigation went down gradually, and there are several papers that would tell you that there are errors. You heard that earlier as well. But this paper again was from Dan Berry's group. And that suggested that current generation in knee instrumentation allows most surgeons to achieve mechanical axis plus or minus 3 degrees, and most of the remaining outliers are just 1 or 2 degrees from the neutral mechanical axis. And this is the paper from Dan Berry's group, Mayo Clinic. This paper was from Paul Gregg's center and said that relationship between survival of primary knee and mechanical axis alignment is weaker. So more and more evidence started emerging that actually it is not the mechanical axis that you should be chasing at 0 degrees. And there are several papers that tell you that. This paper was from Mark Pagnano's group again. And at 20 years, they said that once again did not confirm that neutral mechanical axis provided better implant survivorships. So there are more factors at play rather than 0 degrees on neutral mechanical axis here. And most of the outliers according to them were 4, 5, 6 degrees, which is a more real world scenario. And this was, in fact, said long ago that factors other than mechanical alignment might be more important in determining the long-term survival of the implants. And again, similar paper, this is Chitranawat study that did not show any improvement in the outcome or longevity of the implant. And the same paper. I'll just run through because, so my use of CAS today and robotics IX is considered to be an extension of CAS essentially for the same reason, is in special situations alone. And I would not hesitate to use because that is the only way you can do knee replacements in these kind of scenarios. And if this kind of patient comes to me today, I do not need to use CAS because I can deliver this same outcome without using CAS, using my all techniques that are at my disposal. And essentially the clinical techniques or surgical techniques that are more important in this scenario. So why would I want to do anything other than conventional jigs in the current scenario today for a routine knee replacement today? And today, what do I think about CAS and robotics? It's an aggressive marketing tool. I think I congratulate Narendra for doing the first robotic in the city. But when I read the newspaper report of you doing a 35-minute robotic as your first robotic, I thought there was a printing error. You missed out 3 hours there. So who does the technology benefit? Surgeon? Of course it does. The town was painted red in this city with banners all over at every corner and media reports appearing every now and then. Company, of course, company is laughing to the bank. So company is very happy. And I'm not so sure whether the patients are being benefited, because all the patients that are coming to you, hopefully you are doing robotic for every one of them. And I find it impossible that you can do 10, 15, 20 robotics every day. Sorry, not possible. So it's no more about science. If I quote Bill Clinton's presidential theme slogan, it's about economics, stupid. And those who buy robotics at the cost of 6 crores or plus, I feel sorry for them. Because the indications become patient having a virgin knee becomes an indication for a total knee. And today I spent significant time convincing the patients who come for a second opinion that they do not need total knee replacement. So technology is welcome, but when it is used for abashed, aggressive marketing, it is sad. And you may be compelled to do that for a simple reason of economics. Use of media for spreading deceit and lies is sad. Neutral mechanical axis is a goal, but is it really a goal? And then has come the concept of kinematic balancing of late. And all these years we were chasing 0 degrees syndrome, chasing 0 degrees of the neutral mechanical axis. This paper is from this year's Journal of Arthroplasty. This is a Arcus symposium. It says pros and cons, a balanced view of robotics in knee arthroplasty. And the conclusions are interesting. Although the presumption has been that the improved alignment associated with robotics will improve function and implant durability, but there is limited data to support that notion. Based on recent and emerging data, it may be reasonable to presume that robotics, presume that robotics is necessary for knee arthroplasty. Unreasonable to produce. So if this is what we need to really prevent on the tibia invaris and that collapses. So the need today is to train young surgeons how to do a good conventional surgery, avoiding the pitfalls of conventional surgery. Thank you very much.